Precision modeling is possible in Blender, and I'm here to show you how. What's up? I'm Jonathan, and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is part of a very beginner series of both Blender and precision modeling. If you haven't seen my very first setup video, I encourage you to do so. It's how to turn Blender into millimeter units. The link is in the card or down in the description. So coming from the millimeter setup video, you will be at this point where currently you have millimeters set up. However, there's still a little bit of housekeeping that I need to address. First of all, I want to address that if you are using a laptop, you're going to have a bit of struggles here. So if you go into edit and go preference, something that you're going to need to do if you're working on a laptop is maybe emulate numpad or forget about all numpad shortcuts. I will do my best to try and point these out, but a little bit of Google searching might be needed. Numpads and a 3-button mouse is essential, really, to do efficient modeling with Blender. One other thing that I forgot to do was one more add-on. This add-on is called Extra Objects Add Mesh. So Add Mesh, Extra Objects. We need this add-on as it's very powerful, as it's something that we'll be using continuously throughout this series. And while we're here, I want to show you one thing on interface. I'm going to be changing my interface to 1.25. This is extremely useful for people who have a very small screen, bad eyesight, or a very high resolution screen. I'm currently on a 4K screen. You're going to see when I hit enter, everything bumps up in size. We will be coming back into the preference window quite often in the beginning of this series, as there are many useful things to still set up. Now with the fundamentals set up, let's go over the viewport. The viewport is this area right here, and the navigation of it is rather simple. If you hold down the middle mouse button, you will rotate around the viewport. If you hold down Shift and the middle mouse button, you will pan in the viewport. If you hold down Control and middle and then move, you will zoom in and out in the viewport. However, you can also use the scroll wheel to zoom around. If you get yourself completely lost and have no idea where you're looking at and everything seems a bit of a mess, this is one of those numpad ones, which if you click the cube here on the right hand side and hit numpad point, this will take you to the cube and fill it to your screen. I have a feeling this can also be done somewhere here in the view options, but I'm not exactly sure where it would be. I think it's here, frame selected. So if you're completely lost out on a laptop, you can go view, viewport, frame selected, and that will take you here. This current viewport is the perspective viewport. We're going to be doing most of our work in something called the orthographic viewport. We're going to be using the Z top axis. So if we hit 7 or the Z here, this will take you to the top view of the viewport. If you go and hold down the middle mouse button and move out, you go straight into the perspective once again. Here you will see it says user perspective, and then when we hit the Z, it's top orthographic. If you click the Z once again, you will be on the bottom orthographic. Just be aware that when the circle is inside of the blue circle, this is the top, this is the bottom. Now, if this is the first time in a 3D program, or a 3D program like Blender, there are two modes to the viewport. One is an object mode, and the other one is an edit mode. If you try and do edits within the object mode, I'm going to be doing a few things that maybe you saw this dimensions here and change this here. This will edit the scale. This is because you are inside of the object mode and not the edit mode. I'm doing Control Z to undo two steps. And to go and edit something, you're going to hit Tab or the drop down here into edit mode. Now, before we go any further, I want to explain the very fundamentals of 3D modeling within almost all organic-based modeling programs. All 3D objects are made out of these three things: a vertex, which are the points at a corner, edges, which are the edges of an object, and the faces of an object. We're not really going to be working within the 3D space right this minute, but it's good to just know these. We will mainly be working with edges and vertices for this video. To start off with, I want to select and delete everything. So first, I will show you how to select. If you left click and drag, you have this box, and we're selecting right this minute because we're in the vertex edit mode, the vertices. If you want to select more than one vertex, you can drag and select both of them, or you can do shift and drag to select another one. Or if you wanted to unselect one, hold down control to unselect one. You will see right this minute that if I try to select everything there, I'm not actually selecting everything because on the other side of the cube, this is unselected. To select absolutely everything inside of edit mode, you hit A to select the whole object. To delete something, hit X to delete it. This will give you a little menu to say what you want to delete, and we want to delete all the vertices here to give us a completely blank canvas. To start off with, I want to go into the top view. So let's go into the top view by hitting Z or 7. From here, let's create a vertex by going Shift A. This will let us have the option of doing single vert, add a single vert, and this creates a single vert around in this point here, which is our 3D cursor. We will go into more detail soon about this. Just know that this thing here is something called the 3D cursor, and you have our cursor right here. So now make sure that if you're in the face select mode, you're not going to be able to select this vertex. So make sure you're in the vertex selection mode or edit mode, vertex, select your vertex, and now we're going to hit E. This extrudes the vertex. As you see, it's like an Illustrator or Rhino in some of my other videos. It's giving you this line. Remember that a vertex is a point in space that doesn't really have any substance or edge or creation to it. So we have to add more vertices to create an edge. So we have extruded a vertex to create this line. This line is actually a mesh, a wire, or an edge, but it's free floating. So let's constrain it. This here is our Y axis, and this here is our X axis. So if we hit X, we've just constrained this extrusion to the X axis. Let's say I only want this to go out for 10 millimeters. Let's put in 1, 0. That's gone out to the 10 millimeter line. Now, if you want to see how far this is extruded, I haven't clicked yet. You can see here, D10 up on the top left. If I backspace, that's just 1 millimeter. If I want, I can go 12 millimeters. So let's go 10 millimeters, I can hit enter or click. I'm going to do enter. So this here is now a 10 millimeter extrusion. If you're finding it a little bit difficult to see the vertices and this line that's being created, I want to show you a little quick little tip. Inside of edit and preferences, you can go inside of themes and inside of 3D view. And if you scroll right down to the bottom, you have this vertex size. If you click and drag, you can change the size of the vertex. You can also put in a value. I'm going to keep mine at 3. However, if you find that the line between these two vertices is also really hard to see, you can actually go all the way up here and change this wire edit to a color that's more visible. If you find this line is still too small, inside of Interface, you can actually turn all the lines in Blender to thick. This makes everything a lot more visible in Blender. Now that we have a 10mm line, let's get really precise. Let's extrude out a 10.15 millimeter line on the Y axis. So first try this yourself. I hope you gave that a try, because trying it out is how you're going to be learning here. So select the vertex, hit E to extrude, and this time we're constraining it to the Y axis, and we're going, I think I said 10.15, so up on the top left, 10.15, and click. So now here we have a 10.15 line. You might be asking, okay, so getting a little bit tedious to have to put in these numbers by hand. So I will show you how to do precise snapping within Blender. So this here is the snapping tool and lets you set what exactly you're going to be snapping to. So I'm going to put absolute grid snap of increments, which means now when I select my vertex and I hit E, nothing is snapping. However, if I hold down control, I am now control snapping to my grid. As you see, if I try to go out to do that 10mm extrusion, we're actually losing that 0.15mm. So what we can do is constrain ourselves to the X and then do our snapping. And that has left us with our 1.5 little gap that we gave ourselves here. Now I'm going to close off this square by selecting these two vertices. I'm going to use PDT, Design Tools, and Join Two Verts. This will join two vertices together. This here, technically, is a closed loop. And inside of Edit Mode, you can actually select everything and click F to fill it. This fills and creates your first face in Blender that is exactly 10mm by 10.15mm. Okay, before we go ahead and add a hole in it in the next video, let's add another shape onto this. So let's Control Z to undo. Let's hit 7 to go back up. If you're on a numpad, if you don't have a numpad, you're going to have to hit Z. And let's say I wanted to add another cube right up here, but it was exactly at the midway point between these two, and I don't want to calculate that. So what's the first thing I want to do? I'm going to go into Edit Mode. I'm actually going to go into Edge Mode, sorry, and Edit Mode here. I'm going to hit X, and I'm going to delete this edge. And then I'm going to go back into Vertex Mode. You can quickly go into these three modes by going 1, 2, 3. I'm sorry if you have a laptop and you've done the numpad, you won't be able to do this. You'll have to do it by going up here. So what we're going to do is move our 3D cursor into the exact middle point here so that we can create a vertex at the exact point that is the middle. To do this, we are going to select one, select the other. We're going to use PDT. And right here, we have do one at percent between selected points. We're wanting 50% because we're wanting right in the middle. Our working plane up here, make sure we set that to top as it's going to be important in future videos. And we're going to go and set this. Make sure we're setting one, do one. Number one here, we're setting the origin operation of the move cursor. And what we're moving cursor-wise is our 3D cursor. So we're going to hit this. And that's just moved our 3D cursor right there. This lets us now do Shift-A to create a single vertex. I'm going to add a single vertex right here. Now, I want you to extrude this out 10mm and 10 millimeters upwards. I hope you tried that. So going to extrude this, we're going in the X by 10, and then we select this, we're going to extrude it on the Y by 10. Now, let's say for some reason we don't know what the exact point is right here, where these two lines intersect. So to do this, I'm just going to extrude this on the Y by a little bit, and I'm going to extrude this one on the X by a little bit too. So what we're wanting to know is the intersection point between these two points. To do that, we select these two, and we then select these two. The order is important. You have to select one and then select the other line. And then make sure that we're on the working plane of the top view. And right here where it says intersect, this is going to calculate the intersection, move our 3D mouse to the point, and that there is the exact intersection point of our two lines. Once again, we can now do Shift A, create a vertex right at that point. We can now select these points, hit X, and then delete these vertices. We can now join our shape together by selecting them and join the vertex. Select them and join the vertex. Select these and join the vertex. Now, if we select everything and hit F, you have your first intricate shape created millimeter precise in Blender 2.8. Congratulations, you've just scratched the surface of precision modeling in Blender. Trust me when I say this, that this is no small feat, as this is literally the fundamental foundations of precision modeling in Blender. And I really encourage you to do the challenge, which is going to be for you to go and do the floor plan of your house using exactly what you've just learned. Things that are going to be coming up after this course are how to create a hole within a flat surface, as well as how to export this as a vector file accurate to scale to be able to use with a CNC or laser cutter. After that, we will go into adding a whole nother dimension to our precision modeling. A big shout out to my Patreons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and I'd love it if you want to support me too. Thanks for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.